Hello, good morning, good evening, and every other time in between. Let's hop into this. How you doing, Queen? Hopefully you can put up your feet for today. Now we're going to continue where we left off. If you remember yesterday, we had our guess do wheel. And we just basically talked about some of the impacts of the Norse on England and the English language. Hopefully they leave you alone. Being on call is stressful, even if you just try to think of the money. Let's see how close we are to actually getting our mustering grounds. About 20 years. Seems like we'll get two technologies at the same time. Now we are pushing to grab Iceland. And basically to give our unlanded sons different land. But somebody messaged me on YouTube, and you know who you are, thank you very much for pointing out this. If we give an independent realm outside of Norway to our second-born son, and then make his brothers, who would inherit land, vassals of him, and then give him independence, when Kiefer dies, it will count as an independent land in these little areas right here. And all I would have to do is declare one single duchy war, so it's sort of a little bit of a meta play, but it would work. Instead of throwing Norway into a giant civil war. So we'll see how this goes. And we're gonna throw immediately into another war just to finish off this duchy. As soon as that's ready, we'll launch down here and we'll hit this Pickish Lord. Luckily, he doesn't have hardly any military strength, so that's good. Kenneth McAlvin, that's a different story. He doesn't have much military strength either. Surprisingly. Charlemagne's still alive. Actually, he's at war claiming this little section of his kingdom. Didn't even take up our full military size. Speaking of holy orders, though, we can go ahead and bring up some Yorn Vikings. And we're gonna have them just come and harass down here. You would think he would be. I see, he's not even there yet, so we'll give one of the one of our sons. The one that we actually care about, Sigurd. He needs to have some military experience. Let's see who we got captured. Well, we can just sacrifice them. They're not too important, so not worthy of a big sacrifice. Hill forts are definitely going to be something up here. Ah, good, one of our daughters. See about marrying her off to somebody. One of our internal vassals, just to guarantee their loyalty. That's basically what you want to do when it comes to internal alliances, is just basically make sure they're allies for you. Oh, that's not good. Hopefully it's not breaking. Let's see. We need another wet nurse since we do have some youngins. Some children. As long as they've got good attributes. I'll be right back, everybody. Alright, just gotta fix a couple things real quick. Yeah, my granddad just had surgery on Friday. Had to have a pacemaker put in. Just had to run out real quick and help him with something. Luckily, he lives just right next door. Somebody was taken prisoner. They weren't in our lands. Well, this war's about to be over and we'll have everything for the Northern Islands captured. Yeah, to be fair, Queen, they didn't tell me until after it happened, so, hey. Brittany's going crazy. And their king is supported by Charlemagne, so that's definitely not going to succeed. There we go. Another area to turn into Nordic. So we have it on convert culture and the religion. So these will eventually become proper Nordic. And again, somebody's trying to murder our son, probably one of his brothers. Before we do anything, we haven't done this in a little while. And not yet in this playthrough. We're gonna go on a quick little grand tour just to show off our majesty. So we're gonna go here, 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 here. And then drip down to this one, and then back home. And just have grand feast across each one of them. And we're missing some money. Yeah, even cheap. I hate how it tells you that you can afford to do it even though you can't do it. Like, it says go on a grand tour, but obviously I can't do it. And our supply base is finally about to be under way down here. Well, why do we wait for that? We're gonna launch just a grand war against all four of these, because they don't really have any external allies to worry about. So nice little quick succession. They might band up and actually try to fight us off. We'll gather up our forces down here. Raise them all up along with our holy order. Make one big army. We'll get that all raised up pretty quickly. All that up real quick. Now let's knock these guys out first. Actually, I would say let's hit this one. There we go. All the prestige that we have, we don't really need to worry about our army. Something nice about having the being tribal is we don't really need to worry about having a lot of gold or using it up. Because our armies run off on how famous we are. And we're a living legend. And the long ships are away with the army. The great fleet. Able to break these guys down. We outnumber them quite heavily. But But I don't want to take too much losses, so we're going to actually fight this battle. Then we'll have a look at this Irish army. Crusader Wars. Valhalla awaits us. This is the glitched out map. A fun one. Got our Huskarls, our big axes. I think our standard army of just the levies will do fine. We'll have the Jorn Vikings, the big axes, over here. And we'll put this group right here. And we'll put the knights, have our champions lead them. Who's ready for a good scrapping?
Numbers.
Yeah, unfortunately, this map is a glitched out map. Just certain areas of the terrain are messed up. I'll just have them all speed up and get over here. Thank you. Alrighty. Have the spearmen get into a shield wall.
Orders!
And here they come. See what they're trying to do. Not a smart move on their part. And they're surrounded, just being chopped to bits.
Warrior, the general has been killed. Excellent. Moral. God speak good.
We are moving
away from victory.
Minimum on our important losses. I'm guessing since the AI isn't allied up here, they're not grouping up. Because if they would have grouped up into a nice big fight, that would have been interesting. So how is everybody doing today? I hope everybody's having a lovely day. already. Let's see how much. There we go. A nice clean victory. Still 8 months. Why we wait for that? Let's see. Don't really have anything new for our royal court. But it is nice to see it full of people. It's like, I swear there's a way to. There we go. View it all. I really wish that they would update the free camera mod for in here. Like, it's nice just being able to look around and see all the different pieces of the court. Ah, it looks like Sigurd's wife is pregnant again. Looks like another one of our daughters is about to come of age. Does he have in there? Levy a bunch of special soldiers, so he's actually a decent threat. Because they did the adventuring. Looks like Charlemagne is winning quite comfortably over here. And we got ourselves a granddaughter. Look at that. For shame, she is spindly. We'll have one of her uncles educate her in the ways of diplomacy. Our Jarl and friend, right from the very beginning, is an amazing diplomat, now up to 40. Have the future queen. Be the spy master. Our cupbearer has died. Give her some court experience. Station besiegers and march on these guys. Oh, there's no dragons though. I know, it's a shame. An adult. This will do. A nice wife for him. And that's the first. And we missed that fight. Must have went over pretty quickly. This would be Panda's territory if he, you know, wasn't sacrificed. We'll have our second-born son from our original wife take over this area. Poor panda. He's eating bamboo eternally. Succession. marry her off. So all we have left to do is give our two youngest land and make sure these are part of their vassals. Actually, I just noticed something. Actually, I don't mind him getting that territory. It's not part of this area up here. There we go. Now that siege is done, march up here. And our wife will help us with our education. Just need one more and we can form the title up here. So this island has been turned into the Shetland Sea. This has been successfully turned into a Nordic island. Just need the same for down here. In particular, I want one of these to have a marketplace to extend our range. Now, as long as our, basically, as long as none of his descendants and him himself doesn't rebel, and the same thing goes with our son that we just put up here, these two will eventually become cadet branches, which will be nice. go, another fight. When we outnumber them so heavily like this, we're just gonna let it do its thing. Station besiegers and go hit these guys. With only four survivors, they won't be able to break through the besiegers. I was hoping we could convert her. Oh well. So here's a little fun fact to go on. So the Sami and the Finns, this whole little like area right up here. To the Norse, all of this was just Finnish, and they're all closely related to one another, being the Baltic Finnic group. They do have their own religion, which isn't actually represented in the game. Eventually I'm going to split it off. Kind of have their own little bit of a thing, but for right now we just have them grouped in as a Satru, even though they would eventually go into the Nordic religion later on. Alrighty, all we gotta do now is just station more besiegers and let's go hit this army. Maybe we'll capture him. Visby could be a valuable ally, to be honest. Forming an alliance soon. Surprised they haven't launched some more conquests, to be honest. So I've been kind of looking around and eyeing, and I'm thinking if we capture this duchy and turn this into the independent realm, one, it's going to be far enough away from us that even whenever we do fight the quick little war, it will kind of wear off pretty quickly. And being that they're up here, and if we grab them a nice little actual area, maybe even form the kingdom title and give it to them. They might go on to then push on their own and form the Kavian Rus. Which would be an interesting thing. Something that's fun to always do in this game is just to give one of your random children or brother or something land that you don't have any intention to mess with. And just see what they do. They're all equally independent characters, and we're just gonna disband that army. We don't need them. One thing we might do shortly is start some pillaging, to be honest. We'll place it here. Because we're short on gold. Some more Norse. Eventually, this will no longer be Irish. It'll take a while to get out the insular Christians from the areas up here. We'll send this group to help out up here. There we go. Let's get him a wife. Somebody worthwhile. An Avar. Interesting. This is about to fall. Excellent. And now we have Iceland. There we go. Oh, look at that, Bjorn rocking the awesome, looks like a wolf pelt. Look at him just being a badass. Yeah, the Pilgrim's Guide again. Oh, we will take another one. Actually, let's repair all of our items. Let's first gauge their strength up here. See how well they respond. He is actually ambitious. another ambitious person. I think that was our grandson. No, not one of our grandchildren. We are educating them, though. We're just gonna declare a big old war. And we're gonna sweep through this whole area. Where did I just put the, rally point? I'll just leave it here in Oslo, and we're gonna raise everybody, and the Holy Order. It's not a hostile faith. That's fine, we can do it ourselves. And I think it's time for Sigurd to really prove himself. I'm also gonna call our allies just to help push this all along. But yeah, we'll make her a shield maiden. Where is our allies? It's right in front of my face. I have our son. Go out and hit these guys first. Excellent, we are fighting with the legendary Ragnar Lothbrok on our side. This will please Ofnir greatly. They could technically come around this way. And strike from here. So it'd be interesting to see what way they all go. Oh great, they're one of those allies sitting in the water. Wait, what's going on? Instead of take the initiative, at least Ragnar is taking the initiative. Might be why they haven't actually continued to expand. It's like they have the option to do it. It looks like they were successful at taking that territory. So outside of the Iberian territories, this is basically Charlemagne's empire at its maximum extent. Just needs to grab a few territories in Iberia, and his quest chain will be done if he continues. Surprised he doesn't have a different heir, since the one that's hired right now is, well, not hired, but the next emperor will be incompetent, incapable. Ragnar's already over here before we even got over here. Look at him go! Ah, one of our younger sons. We get into a snowball fight with him. I like that one of our options was to just go berserk on him. Ragnar finished that one off. Our second-born son, this territory here. Let's arrange his marriage. I will attempt to translate the old scroll. A Saxon woman who still follows the old ways. Study that battle. We'll have them marry. Just need 8 counties to form this kingdom, so it's a quick kingdom to actually form. Jeez, Ragnar just blasting through all this. And we'll grant him a title up here. And you will have the younger, the other title, I mean, not the younger title. All we need to do now is just finish off this little area here, and we'll be good. Go ahead and form that title soon. See what money we can get from those. That was weird, that was 100% and then not. I think it's because we just accidentally ransomed him off. Oh well, more money. Won't be long. Would you want to become a vassal? And he's a berserker. Awesome. Didn't even have to continue what was left of Norway right there. It's awesome whenever they join up for free. Clobber them down in a bit. 14 more days. Now, which of these three brothers are actually the more ideal? Definitely not him. see. So it really comes down to our second born or our third born, and I'm gonna say our third born, though he is an albino. Actually, no, the Stuart gives him 5 counties, much better. Take that title. Oh god, I gave him the wrong one. Would you gladly, gotta wait. Lovely. Oh, whoopsies. That happened. Cool, Sigurd's become a hunter. And we got a Inspiring Blade Master. Nice little random event. Will grant him another title, though, his proper title. And I just want that northern county. And we'll send all the armies up here to beat him down real quick. While I look at the next major target, which will be both of these little areas. King of his own right, in his own right, would be awesome. And Kiefer has actually done something quite nice. Because as soon as we're done with this little county conquest, we've grabbed all that is de jure. De jure, or however you would actually pronounce it. But all the territory that is supposed to be part of Norway. Yeah, we're on our way to making another kingdom title that we're going to give away to one of our sons. The founder of our dynasty in the beginning of our whole legacy, and we're still obscure, but that should definitely go away quite soon, as soon as we grab another area. It's going quite nice. Grabbing these two should give us enough to actually create the title. And we'll just finish off the entire area.
Ah!
won't be too long, then we can hopefully take this title off of them. Little oopsies like this. Not good. Can we make another accolade, actually? Not quite. Have our son is quite far down. Continue the fight. See if there's anybody else. We'll sacrifice them. Oh, we're either going to get assassinated or this is a birthday party. And it's a birthday party! I love how there's like no in between with this event. It's either a birthday party or you're about to die. And I think we're going to take the biggest one. And it gave us a sword. A sword that we don't really need. But you know who could use a sword? Our son. I will gift him the Norse sword. And it always takes forever fighting in the hills. Upland launching a campaign over here. And we'll actually offer to join this war because he helped us. So we will return the favor. And why not? We'll actually call him to the war real quick. Might as well. Excellent. And we'll plunge our army right at their capital after we finish off this siege. I think we can also go ahead and remove. Not yet. Getting close. She could be a decent wife for our grandson. With the martial trait. We'll have to see about that. We're 52, so we could die at any time now. Let's see. That army attacking Upland's gonna do a lot more damage. Station besiegers, go hit this guy. And now we got our alliance a lot better. So, Ragnar's son, I think this is the one that's going to inherit. No, it's not. One of his sons, though, has a shield maiden wife, which is always fun. Nordic battle queens. And we got another grandson, and he's a giant. I won't let him be named. After Sigurd. Definitely being made a warrior. One of his uncles would probably be better. Our court physician. They're good at educating. Right, beating down this army. Look at our son go, leading the armies in Norway. He makes his father proud in the name of Alfheim. Not much longer, and we'll have all of Norway. One of our children have died. I am so so hurt. He was slain in battle. That is fine with me. That one will go there. He will go there. No, that's not what we wanted at all. That's not good. We take that title, we gotta pull that off of them. That's probably going to give us a civil war right there. See what happens. Not as bad as I thought it would be. To this war. And we'll call Ragnar as well. As soon as we finish this. Excellent. My chancellor and best friend betrayed me. Strength and success. Being a berserker, that's how it is. Can we Revoke your title. Please don't rebel. I don't like that. Oopsie. Good, good. We shall send him a gift. So now to fix this up. He will be forbidden to be one of our knights because I want him to live. Station besiegers, and we're going to our capital before it becomes a problem. Actually, we are going to their capital. Take down our son before he gets himself hurt. He might lose his birthright in favor for one of his children. There we go. We'll send them over here and our primary army. We'll come back around. Strike them here. See our second to youngest son. Ask him to join a holy order, and he will not, even though he is a soldier of the faith. Make him brave. That's our boy. I'm really thinking about giving our title to somebody else. Possibly one of our younger sons. The Lionheart. I think we're just gonna give it to Bjorn. With a nickname like the Lionheart? Heck yeah. We are going to go... How do we do the vote? See, who are the electors do we want to get? Okay, they're all voting for who we want. And we now have a new heir. Bjorn the Lionhearted has become our favored. And we will no longer be educating our two grandchildren from him. Oh, good, they're sending them to be educated. How does the succession look now? So we'll put our two youngest sons over here. Because, let's just go and say, he's gonna have his title revoked and he's gonna be made an example. The Eastern Roman Empire is still in a civil war. Crazy. It might eventually stabilize. To the point that Charlemagne has gotten involved. Yeah, they're allied with one another. That's interesting. And look at this guy's his nickname is the Bearded. Look at that. And he's learned Norse. And hello. Welcome to the channel. Alright, all we gotta do now is just finish off our son. And his allies. Send him around here. So currently we are doing a nice slow play. So just sit back, relax, grab a drink. Looks like Tartaria is starting to fall apart. Kyrgyzstan. And the Abbasids are still holding strong and looking scary. Won't be long. I swear this little mess up caused a civil war. His whole bloodline is to be cut out. Will make us unpopular, but it's gonna also make us very scary. And he ran away. I like it. I mean, it's a little flavor pack. You are revoking your title. You're gonna be publicly executed for your treachery. He will be murdered. You will be murdered. You shall be executed. And you announce claims, and you're coming into my court. Grant titles to one of our younger sons. And grant the jarldom over here. Yeah, Tours and Tournaments is pretty good. Adds a lot of roleplay. She shall be married off to somebody to keep them loyal. To negotiate your release, renounce those claims. I want a weak hook on you. You better behave. Thank you. I appreciate the follow. Good. Arrange. You why can't we have her marry? That works. And it'll give support to up here. Let's take a look. Excellent. Now we can educate him the way we want. Fine military focus. We shall also give him a better name. Actually quite like Bjorn, so he'll be Bjorn the Second. Absolute control. I swear, every time we go through each one of our playthroughs, we have one part where we just have regular child murder. Ransom off these guys. But we got Norway finally all the way under control. We've achieved actually a good bit of stuff, and we're feeling a little generous, so we're just gonna have a little extra sacrifices. Please the gods a little bit more. Offer them all up to Alfmir. And let's see what the court's doing. That one worked. And we never hold court because it's just completely irrelevant to what we're actually doing. And another runestone. Now a new activity. We're gonna go could have a tournament. Let's have a feast. A grand feast. There we go. This should make them like us a little bit more, and bring back any vassals who have lost a little bit of faith back into our sphere, which, honestly, none of that really caused any major issues. Just converting areas to our religion and to the Norse culture. Luckily, this area is already Nordic. At least the part that matters. And our dynasty is now finally off of obscure and into insignificant. So we're finally moving up in the world. And it will go up quite a bit when we get our second kingdom title over here and give it off to our second-born son. This will hopefully encourage him to also start spreading, and maybe he'll form the Kabyan Rus. It's always fun just to see what happens when you release them out into the wild. But having another Nordic kingdom up here will be pretty fun. Ragnar Lothbrok, even though he's now called the King of Beauty and Nobilis, doing well. He's gonna form a... I think he can actually go ahead and form Sweden. Not far off. Wish they would just hurry up and finish forming Denmark. We might have an actual opportunity to outright fight Charlemagne proper. Wessex has expanded a little bit. And I think we'll finish up to the end of the year. And we'll call it a day for today. Slow plays are nice, just sit back, relax. Enjoy the role play, which ours has just been going around and forming Norway now that we've done that. Sort of just having our ambitions up here. Oh, that's fun. Just like that, we don't have to worry about the rise of Kenneth MacAlvin anymore. See, did he die? Choked to death on his food. So it was his daughter that lost it. I would invite her, but it's not giving me the option. And we can have our feast. I'm gonna pin her. Might reinstall them up here and kinda get the McAlvins in power. Might be a valuable ally to have whenever we press eventually down here. If we do, that is. Forming our friendships a little closer. Our big thing is just getting allies for the potential civil war that we're gonna have. Well, the little fight that we're gonna eventually have. On succession. Got another granddaughter over here. Since we weren't intending on him becoming a vassal by himself, well, becoming king. He is now. Send a gift. We'll figure it out. We'll figure out what we're gonna do with her in the next episode. So, I'd like to thank you all for coming by. Remember to give us a like and subscribe on YouTube, and give us a follow, and if you're generous enough, give us a subscribe over here on Twitch. And remember, if you're watching this over here on YouTube and you want to catch any of these streams live, come over here onto Twitch anytime you want. We stream every weekday and occasionally on the weekends. And we'll be seeing you all later, you alligators. Bye-bye now. Check out real quick, see if we got anybody to raid before we actually end the stream. We're gonna go over and raid Panda now. Remember, hashtag Panda was sacrificed. And we'll be seeing you all later. See you later. Bye-bye.